Thank you. Yeah. Anytime.
It hasn't proven to be any different right now.
As Gibbs gets kicks to Davis. Courtney Harris with it. Lumpkin, sorry, with it. Gibbs tries a three, too strong. And now these are the opportunities where Dillard has to push. Buchanan hasn't crossed half court, well, just now crossing half court. Harriet Hayford with the board. And those are the opportunities that Dillard's going to need to thrive on. Pushing it in transition so that Buchanan doesn't have an opportunity to get low in that paint and be a rim protector.
Yes, because I can already tell, like, just by the beginning of this game, Buchanan is not leaving the basketball game at all. At least if Fisk plans to win, she's going to be in the entire game. So I think if you make her run, you have to tiger her out. Because she is an All-American for a reason. But I think if you tire her out, see, just like the opportunities like this, you have to score those. Those are critical opportunities to win in basketball games, not letting those easy buckets get away from you.
Yeah, absolutely. We see, you know, Fisk, after every bucket, they want to press. They want to set up that diamond and one. But with Buchanan at the back of that diamond and one, you know, she's not able to get from paint to paint as quickly as everybody else. So it's going to be those opportunities. A nice no-look pass by Gibbs. Bibbs.
What a nice move by Bibbs right there. On the quick stop right there. I love it.
As that three by Zaria Knox is blocked. And, you know, we talked about guard play here early in this one, and the two guards for Fisk, Liz Gibbs and Jayla Bibbs, you know, they've been everywhere. You know, they might not have been scoring yet, but trust me, their presence is being felt defensively.
Definitely. A lot of pressure, a lot of aggression. A lot of aggression has been shown by these Fisk guards earlier, and I'm really loving the aggression because that's what makes other teams fold. Right? You got to put pressure on the guards, and force the guards to make a play. You can't let the guard be comfortable, let them read the court. No, you have to get in their chest, force them to make turnovers, and force them to make plays.
Absolutely, is Hayford's unable to corral that offensive rebound. Gibbs swings it to Anaya Young. She takes Hayford all the way to the hoop, unable to get it to fall. Knox pushes it up to Dawson. Dawson with the reverse lay. Not enough English on it, and we're headed the other way. Lumpkins all the way to the hoop, fouled by Dawson.
You see, the same way Fisk is attacking the basket, I would like to see the same thing do. You see how she goes, into her body and tries to draw the contact and then still attempting to get the shot. You have to do that a lot to draw the foul. You can't just draw the foul by just trying to, you know, just try to look forward. No, you have to still try to attempt it, but you just got to be physical. Put your shoulder into the opponent and try to get the layup.
Lumpkins misses that first one. She had 10 points in their last game in a win over Talladega. She gets the second one to fall. Dawson back to Diaz in the middle to Cassidy Lowe. And now the press is broken. Dillard's able to get into the half court set. Cassidy Lowe swings it to Knox, coming off the screen from Hayford. Nice hezzy, swings it to Diaz. Diaz off the screen from Hayford, looks for the pull-up, gives it back to Hayford on the pop. Nice long two there by Hayford. And you know, not the prettiest execution there, but execution nonetheless.
I thought she was going to roll that first one, but I think the best option would be the ball. I'm happy she made the shot.
Lumpkins loses it. Diaz kicks it to Knox. Knox with a strong layup, too strong. Dawson dives on it, gets it to Cassidy Lowe. And we have a timeout called by the Blue Devils. 16-10, your score here. The Lady Bulldogs there in front. We got about a minute 40 left. We'll bring you back to action after this short break. Welcome back to the Battlefield, Blue Devils fans. We have a 10-16 game here. Fisk up 6 on the Lady Blue Devils with a minute 14 left here in this first quarter. Diaz gets it in the low. Knox with it. Going to run a set here. Diaz coming off the down screen with an elevator screen. Sidestep long two. And that's good. See, these minutes here when Buchanan is off the court is where Dillard's going to have to get aggressive and start, you know, applying some pressure back to these Lady Bulldogs.
They have to make the most of the opportunities. That's a tough look.
Yeah. As Buchanan off the assist from Lumpkins. Dawson takes it the other way with a floater.
These opportunities, those 3-on-1 opportunities are definitely going to make the game. There's a lot of, what I'm saying is there are a lot of missed passes. A lot of missed passes and opportunities that they're not making. I think if they just make one more pass, quick pass, read the defense, I think everything will work out. But they will do. From what I want to see from Fisk is I love their aggressive defense, but I think their offense, from the offense, I would just keep going to Buchanan, honestly. Because it's like, what I'm saying is on the Dillard side, they don't have as much personnel or anyone that's able to deal with the physicality from Buchanan on the offensive end. And Buchanan is what I would say describe as like a Jokic. Draw the double team, hit the man in the corner, wide open.
And we've seen her already do that here in one with the assist to Lumpkins in the corner. You know, Dillard's just going to have to, like I said early in the first quarter, you know, they're going to have to start fronting her and stop denying these entry passes. As we see right there, made that a tougher catch. You know, she had to worry about the baseline there.
Much harder pass to make is trying to get that pass right over the shoulder, especially with that back heel. You know it's going to be backside heel because this is your best player.
Shot clock winding, well, play clock winding down here. Shot clock off low in the short corner. Unable to get it to go, but it's going to stay Dillard basketball as Zipporah Davis isn't able to corral that one. 2.5 seconds left in the first quarter. Fist still up 6, 18-12. Diaz is going to look to inbound. Gets low on a dive, and that's an excellent inbound play, an excellent way to close out a back-and-forth first quarter between these two teams.
Dillard really picked it up at the end of the quarter. I was happy to see that. I'm looking forward to seeing how the rest of this game will progress because I'm starting to see a lot more adjustments being made on the defensive side of Dillard and also some adjustments being made. No, I haven't seen many adjustments from Fisk right now, but I've seen a lot of adjustments from Dillard. I'm liking that. I'm ready to see what Fisk will come out with in the second quarter.
All right, we're going to give the players a break here. I'm going to bring you back this second quarter here on Blue Devil Sports Network. Welcome you back to the second quarter here inside the battlefield at Dillard University. A 4-point game, 18-14, Fisk Bulldogs in the lead. Ahmad, you said you were starting to see some adjustments on the defensive end by Dillard. What have you seen specifically that's, you know, helped them carve into this lead?
Well, first, I'd like to say by starting to front Buchanan rather than trying to play from behind. I think it's better the front because now you force a much harder pass to make. Now she is going to try to use her force to make that pass, to try to shorten that pass, but I just think it's a better overall option to do when you're facing the oversized defense.
Just able to get that friendly roll there. That's Zipporah Davis. She has 8 points here in this one, the second leading scorer behind Buchanan. And this is what Dillard's gonna have to continue to do offensively. Make Buchanan defend. Make her stay in front and guard the ball. You see Dillard going back to a zone here, trying to front Buchanan as much as possible. Excellent read there by Diaz to get a hand on that one. Going to be essential for them to have that communication there on the back line. That is a travel before anything. And you can hear Coach Rowe down there telling her players, you got to do your work early, meaning, you know, get in front of Buchanan early so, you know, she's not even able to get the ball that deep into the paint.
Have to deny that entry pass because as soon as they get the entry pass in there, you might as well just say another turn.
Buchanan gets that first one to go. And Davis with 11 points here in this one. She scored half of Fisk points so far in this one, as that one is too strong. Dillard still trailing by 6. Knox brings it into the front court. Winter Taylor open for 3 to lefty, gets it to go. That's going to be the first 3-pointer made for Dillard here in this one. Back to a 3-point advantage for Fisk. This Lumpkins with it. She gets it to Gibbs. Gibbs swings to Bibbs. Hits the flash in the middle. Davis. offensive rebound by Buchanan, and she just goes straight back up with it. As Low gets the high post jumper to fall. Dibs with it. Gets it. Lumpkins gets it to Gibbs, guarded by Rowe.
Press them up higher and make them have to force that pass. And it also makes them can't have to come up to extend that 2-point zone out and make those guards have to make plays, just like how Fish is making Dillard's guards make plays.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, that last possession we just saw from Dillard is, you know, the kind of possessions that Dillard can't have. You know, Buchanan didn't make it past half court till about 10 seconds into the shot clock. And that was a prime opportunity to attack the basket and get an easy one. But yet, you know, we settled for a long jumper, and he's going back the other way.
Yes, the main reason I believe that Dillard is really just behind right now is because they're just simply not making shots. I think that's the biggest thing. Like, shots will fall. Yes. And our statistician, he just said that Dillard is shooting really, that's what he said. 33% from the field. It's really just simply they are not making shots. Even though they're still in this game, once the shots start falling, I think it might start to get out of hand.
Yeah, and, you know, Dillard's shooting 9 of 27 right now. They shot 37% from the field in the last matchup, over 40% from three in that overtime loss. But, you know, despite Buchanan being the force that she is on the interior, you can't allow guards to be getting offensive rebounds as well, because that just adds to the problem. Denise Armstrong laces in a three. Saved by Gibbs. Zaria knocks with a breakout, runaway. Those are the opportunities that Dillard's going to have to look to exploit. Forcing more turnovers so they can get out in transition. Fisk is not a good transition defense team. We've seen that so far in this one. Buchanan has just been a tough cover all first half. She has 15 points.
He's just such a force. He's just such a force in that interior.
Goes back on the offensive. There's it down low. Stolen away by Jordan Rowe. She has Sequoia Emanuel out on the run as Winna Taylor. It looked like she rolled her ankle on a Euro. Fisk takes it with a 5-on-4 advantage. Buchanan knocks down the elbow jumper. Taylor's still down on the other end.
She lost her shoe on that too.
Yeah, you can tell she's in pain right now. Barely putting any weight on that right ankle. Jordan Rowe steps into a three. Just long. Yeah, they're going to have to get Winna Taylor off there as soon as possible. I suggest taking a take foul. As we have a media timeout. We're going to sort out some of the technical difficulties with the shot clock. And we'll bring you back this live production of Blue Devil Sports here on Blue Devil Sports Network.
That's what I want to see more of from Dillard. Like, they have to force the guards to make plays. Force the guards to get involved into the game. You can't just let one player beat you, especially if you know, like, that they have so much in the game. Like, she has 19 out of their 33 points. That's like more than half of their points. From now, I'm going to start seeing that we need to force the ball away from her and force the guards to try to score and make plays.
Definitely forcing more ball pressure and going to make some of these entry passes to Buchanan a little harder. Dillard able to retain possession and stuff it under the goal.
Yes, I love the hustle. Makes the game harder. Be scrappy. Be desperate for the ball. Show that you want it more. Try to get a lot more buckets inside. While we're seeing on Dillard's side, it's a lot more motion offense, trying to move the ball around, trying to, you know, get back their cuts. But I believe they just pick it up, make it a lot more aggressive. That will lead to a lot more opportunities.
Jones lines up the top of the key three. Can't get the phone on the road.
Call Buchanan inside. They're calling Buchanan. They're calling any fouls around Buchanan. He just puts his hands on. I'm not liking that. It just doesn't seem even to me. A little bit to a point, but it's just. But if you got to call the same thing on the top.
Absolutely, there's been contact on both sides. You know, you mentioned the fact that Dillard isn't attacking the paint as frequently as this game, but regardless, if these are going to be the calls that's made throughout the game, then they're going to have to be made on both sides.
Definitely, I definitely agree with that.
As Buchanan takes a breather, now Fisk a little smaller when it comes to height on the court. Rowe running the offense. Ooh, nice move there. Floater again, and that one drops.
Go.
That's 7 points here for Jordan Rowe. And the lead is cut down back to three in favor of the Fisk Bulldogs. Davis kicks to Gibbs. Swing to Robinson. Can't get it to go. And Gibbs tries to throw it off of Jones, but it ends up hitting her again. And we're going back to the Lady Blue Devils with a chance to cut this down to one or tie it up before
half. Fisk isn't even pressing right now, so I would definitely take advantage of them not trying to press right now. Now, I say drive right here because Buchanan is not in the game. That's a lot less. The paint defense is nowhere near the same right now.
Yeah. Rowe kicks to Jones. Jones on the attack. Calling for the screen from low. She gets it, comes off of it. Drive baseline, kick, Swing pass to Emmanuel. Another floater. Good. 1 point game. Oh, turnover in the backcourt. And just like that, Dillard gets their first lead of the night. They're keeping up the defensive intensity.
And now they're picking it
nice
up.
Nice trap. Steal by Rowe. Doesn't get it off in time. But what an excellent run to close off this first half by the Lady Blue Devils.
And just like I said before, they have, when you force them to make plays, it shows what a team can really do. It shows whether they really have true ball security. Wow.
And Dillard able to force 8 turnovers here in this first half. They go into the half with a with a 1 point lead. And they're just going to want to kind of build off that momentum that they just were able to spark right there.
They have to keep up that pressure if they're going to win this game. You see, when they pick up the pressure, they force turnovers, quick, easy turnovers. They start making mistakes. When you feel that pressure under a trap, all you feel is just hands slapping down, and you just have to be strong and make a play. Not everybody can do that. Not everybody's good enough to do that right every time. So I think if you just force them to make plays, like they're trying to force Dillard to make plays, they can actually come out and win the game.
All right, and we'll be back here on Blue Devil Sports Network with the second half of this intense Dillard versus Fisk matchup. We welcome you back here inside Dent Hall for our halftime analysis. Ahmad, what did you see in that first half from the Blue Devils that propelled them to this early lead?
Well, it really came down to the end of the half is when the Blue Devils really started to go on a run. But what made the run was just the fact that they started to pressure the basketball a lot more. When they started to pressure the basketball and create turnovers, that's where they got a lot more easier opportunities than before.
We welcome you back inside Dent Hall for the beginning of the second half here in this matchup between the Dillard University Blue Devils and the Fisk Lady Bulldogs. Ahmad, what did you like in that first half from the Lady Blue Devils, and what are some things you could see them improve on?
Well, okay, so what I would like to see them improve on first is just defensive pressure. When they started to apply pressure to Fisk at the end of the half, they went on the big run, which propels them to the lead that they have right now. I believe if you make their guards make plays like if they've been making you make plays, it'll be a lot more different of a game because they're looking to feed Buchanan on the inside for the paint to get most of the buckets because she has 19 out of their 33 points. So I believe if you force their guards to make the plays, it'll prevent the ball from getting to her and it'll lead to a win. But what I would like to see on the Fisk side is I would like to see them move the ball around a lot more. You can definitely find Buchanan on a lot of easy looks because she creates a lot of her buckets on her own, and she gets a foul almost every time she touches the ball. So I believe if you just keep getting the ball in her hands, they're going to come in double, kick it out to the outside, find a three. You can also come back and win this game right now.
Yeah, and we kind of touched on it over the break during halftime. It's a 12-2 free throw disparity in favor of the Fisk Bulldogs. If you're the Blue Devils, how are you looking to kind of even that number out?
Just be a lot more aggressive than what you have been right now. I think now they have been getting down. Now they started off missing floaters. They started to hit a few floaters at the end, which led to them getting into the lead. But I believe if you just attack stronger, you can even manage to get Buchanan in some foul trouble because she isn't doing a lot of motioning on the defensive end. She just stands in one spot, stays close to her man. She doesn't play a lot of help defense because they know she has to stay out of foul trouble in order for them to win this game. So I believe just attack. Be strong with the ball. You'll get a lot more foul calls, and the refs will start, you know, maybe even bail you out at even points.
Yeah, absolutely. That first possession for the Blue Devils results in a air ball going back the other way to Fisk. It's Bibbs with it, guarded by Gee. Feeds it to Buchanan. And just overpowers.
Oh my goodness. Luckily, it was called by offensive foul. I didn't. Honestly, right there, that might be the first one I don't call. That might be the first one I don't call. I look fair right there.
Yeah, and if you've been watching some of these buckets she scored, especially in the first half, you know, she's going to that drop step. She's going to move you out the way with that elbow. It just hasn't been called. Good job of Hayford by selling that one to the officials. As the ball's going back the other way, Gee led, rolled too much.
Yeah, that was definitely a tough call. That was definitely a tough call to get right there. That's what my coach would say. You got to earn your Oscar right there. You got to, you know, make it seem like it's more than what it is. That's one of the things I would like to do, try to, like, force pressure on the guard, make them try to raise the elbow, draw a foul. But I think you can also draw fouls on her like that doing the same thing.
Gibbs gets it in. Buchanan.
Unguarded.
Right
practically
under the
unguarded
basket.
Right there. You cannot allow her to be untouched when the ball goes up under no circumstances, or she will kill you on those boards.
Yeah. And those are points. Number 21 for her and her seventh rebound here in this one. So on the verge of a quick double-double here, you know, points wasn't an issue in that first half.
And the thing is, the double-double is going to happen. She's going to get the ball. So you just have to accept that, but you just have to limit how many rebounds you got. Like, she's going to probably get a good 10 or 12, regular, but you cannot allow her to get to that 20-30 range because that's when she's going to start getting a lot more points off the putbacks and just simple rebounding right there. And most of the rebounds that she has gotten, I believe, have been more offensive than defensive.
And Liz Gibbs walks it down, swings it to Bibbs. Bibbs, tough shot. Didn't really see a foul there, but they're going to call a foul on Gee.
Foul on Gee, first team foul.
It's going to be her first in this one. Jayla Bibbs at the free throw line. Last game just had 4 points in 17 minutes against Talladega. She knocks the first one down. And, you know, going back to that last defensive possession right there by the Blue Devils, you mentioned Buchanan was untouched under the goal, right? It's good to play help side defense. It's essential to play help side defense. But you also have to remember your game plan, you know, during these times. If you rotate in help side, you have to make sure your man is boxing out, you know, Buchanan, just to make sure she doesn't get that easy offensive rebound.
Yeah, but that comes from good. What I would like to say is that comes from a good old drill that I used to run in high school. You have to run that scramble drill. Teach your defense to rotate and just continue to rotate in the different spots. Now, yes, it may create mismatches, but you have to make sure everybody knows to do the exact same thing when it comes to guarding Buchanan. Front her and make her earn that pass and make the guards just earn the pass as well. And make the guards make that pass. Make sure that they're making a good pass. But you also have to have that backside help there for when she tries to reach up and get that. Just pick the ball off right there.
Absolutely. Dillard turns the ball over there again. They're fifth on the game.
To be honest, another one of the improvements that I have missed, it was that their turnovers are a lot less. It's a lot less turnovers than what we're used to seeing. So at the beginning of the season, I would say that they averaged around 10 to 12 turnovers, I would say. But what I'm happy to see is that there is a lot less mistakes being made. They're actually looking with their passes, looking to make good passes and trying to find their man when open. Now, the thing is, I don't really mind turnovers on good looks, but turnovers on the backside of the court, that's what can kill you. Those are easy buckets for the defense. So, yeah, I'm happy to see that for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. Jackson checks in for Hayford. Mai Buchanan has 24 and 9. Rebounds here in this one. Ball knocked away from Lowe, recovered by Rowe, and she gets the mid-range to fall. Dillard's first points of this second half.
And see right there, although they did score, you should not be stopping in transition because you know your man is coming the trail and they're looking for that block. So that's why I'm saying just attack, get the attack and just be aggressive and make Buchanan move out of her position, because even if you miss that layup, it can come out to the other side, and your man has a chance to rebound and just put it right back in.
And that's an excellent defensive position right there by Knox.
I think that's a foul, ref. I'm not going to lie to you.
And it's a 3-on-4 in favor of Dillard. And see, those are the opportunities where you just can't afford to pull the ball back out, you know. Mm-hmm. You have numbers in transition.
Space absolutely eradicated.
And Dillard with their 6th turnover of the game.
Mistakes.
As Davis walks it down off the screen from Buchanan. Strong move to the goal and knocked out of bounds by Rowe.
Yeah, you cannot have mistakes like that on the offensive end. No, you cannot ruin your own space, because the space is your advantage against a team like Fisk like this, because they're not, yes, everybody can move laterally, but not everybody on the floor is able to defend. Like we said before, you have to attack Buchanan. No one has made a move toward her. It's almost like it's intimidating for them to go by. I say just go by her, go for the scoop.
Nice lead pass by Knox to Rowe, and she gets it in. It cuts the lead down back to 2. Robinson comes all the way. Blocked by Gee. I'm going to say she lost it on the way up.
Quick inbound. It has to be a quick
momentum here.
It has to be a quick inbound. Push the floor. She still has her back turn right there. You have to see that pass.
Yeah. And, you know, we We know Dillard is a very set-heavy team. They're going to run their sets. They're going to run multiple sets in one possession. But in games like this where your advantage is going to be in transition as Gibbs comes over with
a stellar help side block.
And if your advantage is playing in transition, then you're just going to have to make the adjustment to get out in transition.
Definitely.
Start forcing turnovers. You know, start inbounding the ball quicker. And, you know, just start running the floor.
Yes.
Zaniah Young gets it to Robinson. Comes off the screen. Definitely a kick ball. Thought the refs were going to let that one play out. As Courtney Lumpkins checks in for Gibbs, who looks a little bit shaken up after that block there on the other end. And, you know, those are the types of looks that Dillard just can't afford to give up, right?
Cannot.
Simple baseline out of bounds. They didn't even run the set, you know.
They're already open.
You know, Young just able to carve out space on the interior and just knock down, well, a little dump-off pass into the paint. As Buchanan comes away with the steal. Lady Bulldogs out in transition. Zipporah Davis for three. Off left.
Yes, foul. Foul ref.
And Lowe's fouled on the board. It's going to be 32 Zipporah Davis there. Whoa, sorry, Anaya Young with the foul. Her first. Jayla Bibbs checks back in for Janice Armstrong.
Media timeout.
And we're going to take a media timeout and bring you back the action of this action-filled second half here on Blue Devil Sports Network. Welcome you back here inside the battlefield of this third quarter. Fisk up four on the Lady Blue Devils as Knox brings it over. And that passing lane is jumped by Lumpkins on the run out. Can't get it to go, but it's Bibbs with the follow. And you see Fisk back in that diamond and one. It's a three-on-one break. And once again, settling for a floater in transition is Dillard.
Yeah, you got to go up stronger than that. You can't just – don't just expect them to give it to you. You have to go in there and you have to earn it.
Lumpkins brings it into the front court. Swings it to Bibbs. Bibbs swings it to Davis. Lumpkins with it back at the top. Sanaya Young with it. Can't get it to go. Jump ball, please. And it's going to stay with the Bulldogs.
Dude, she is
4:06 left in this one.
Buchanan is such a force, man.
Yeah. And that's the same out-of-bounds play that was just ran on the – well, yeah, ran in that last out-of-bounds possession for the Bulldogs.
Yeah.
Anaya Young was able to carve out space to get the easy two for this one, and now she's going to the line off the same action.
You got to know to change your perspective. Like, you have to know that you have to see man and see the ball. you can do. You don't ever want to turn. The problem is they're right there, but they have their back turned to the ball, so they don't even know when the pass is coming. All they see is just ball in the hands, go up quick, free throws.
And, you know, something else I don't really like that's not too fundamentally sound is, you know, Dillard is guarding the inbounder. You know, the inbounder can only pass the ball in right now, so there's no reason to be guarding him. The person responsible for guarding the inbounder should have their head under the basket so those paint touches aren't possible in that setting.
Yeah.
As Bibbs comes away with another steal.
Fish starting to pick up the pressure on the guards again. I would like to see those do the exact same thing if they're looking to win this game. If they do not pressure these guards, they can't go on runs.
Yeah, absolutely. And you see, that's a result of not pressuring these guards, as Buchanan just carves out space with the drop step.
It's just easy passes. You're allowing easy passes. You see how they're playing you, forcing you to make plays, forcing you to make a quick pass. You have to force your opponent to be uncomfortable. If you cannot force your opponent to be uncomfortable, it's hard to win the game. It's hard to win the game. Especially when you know, like I want to see the scouting report, honestly. If I could have seen the full scouting report, I would like to just see, like, what's the scouting report on the guards that haven't been dribbling the ball. Like, it's only been one person bringing up the ball. You need the guard. I would just say guard 94.
As Knox gets the tough floater to go over Buchanan. But if Fisk was a three-point dominant team, you know, they'd be lighting it up from the arc, because when the ball is swung, these Dillard guards aren't closing out.
Even,
so that's why these entry passes have been so, you know, have been so easy to make. They're not discouraging the entry pass or a shot, you know.
Exactly. You have to make them go away. Get your hands up. Hands aren't even active. Hands are in the same place. They're just doing the same thing. They close out and extend the hand close enough to, I would just say, maybe not even to the ball, honestly. But you have to pressure the guards. If you pressure the guards and make them make plays, it makes the game a whole lot different, because now it's harder to feed that big.
Lumpkins with it, guarded by Emmanuel. Nice step back. Gives it to Buchanan at the high post. Buchanan gets it back. Nice drop step and
easy money.
Not too much when she gets it that deep in the paint. 28 points.
And then also you have to think about this. The help isn't right there. As soon as she makes that pass, that help can be right there. She can take that charge because she don't even know you're there. She doesn't even know you're there. You could just take the charge, fall back, see if you can get the call. If you don't get the call, it's fine. Hey, that's one bucket.
Because it's going to be on the floor.
Exactly.
You know.
It's going to be a blocking foul. He didn't even get to go over it.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Dillard almost turns it over again. 2-on-1 here. Emmanuel with the elbow jumper just short. Low with the offensive rebound. Emmanuel with the three. Long.
And if you notice, Buchanan stepped out farther. Buchanan actually stepped out farther right there. She actually stepped out farther right there. And then, because it's almost like she knew. Oh, they're just going to pull up. From the pull up, you have to attack. Give them something new. That's a hezzy right there to an easy layup. That, in my eyes, that's what I'm seeing.
Yeah, absolutely. If these Dillard guards were able to, you know, just stop, make Buchanan freeze for a little bit, then use their quickness to get by her, then
yeah,
this would be a lot different.
And they're also
game.
Not making anybody else beat them but Buchanan. If you look at the score sheet, it's 28. Everybody else is in single digits. 28 out of 49 points. That's definitely about 65% of the points for sure. You have to make someone else beat you. That's the biggest thing.
Yeah, absolutely. Buchanan with a double-double here in this one. 28 points, 10 rebounds. As Gibbs misses the first one and gets the second one to go.
And another thing is they don't even have that many three-point attempts. They only have eight three-point attempts, and they've only made three. They're shooting 38% from the three-point line. That's why I believe you have to force them to make different plays. At this point, I'm starting to double. I'm just starting to double at this point, double and just have somebody rotate a little late, see if they can make shots to a point. You have to make them beat you somewhere else other than just the paint.
Dillard's starting to, you know, get a little bit careless with the ball here.
I'm starting to think I jinxed him.
Yeah, 10 turnovers on the game, 5 in this half. You know, they've already matched
their first half total here in this one. We have about 2 minutes left to go in this third quarter.
Just got to pick it up defensively right now. It's not enough pressure. Like, you can't play off your opponent and you're losing the game by 12. You have to pressure them. You have to.
Diaz splits a pair, but Fisk gets it in quickly in the corner to Gibbs. Gibbs swing to Lumpkins. Tough pull-up jumper. Long, rebounded by Lowe.
I'm going to get the hands on the ball. Thank you. Be strong.
Now, this has to be a fast break opportunity for Dillard.
Go up.
Jean-Baptiste gets it in. And, you know, although that shot didn't go, you know, they're putting pressure on these Lady Bulldogs to get back. Every time there's a defensive rebound by the Lady Blue Devils, they're all, you know, swarming the ball, trying to get their hand in there.
Exactly. It's a lot more scrappy play. I just believe they were just a lot more scrappier. Like, just play desperate. You have to play desperate. If you want to win games and force your opponent to change course of how they're beating you, play desperate. Show a lot more want. Because right now, what I'm seeing from Fisk, they want it more right now. It's a lot more defense, hustle. They're trying to get to those loose balls. I'm not seeing the same thing from Dillard right now.
Yeah, and you can just tell by, you know, how Fisk is jumping the passing lanes on defense. You know, they got back into that diamond.
A lot more. They have a lot more steals, and frankly, they force more turnovers right now.
I think
she got there a little late. That's the only reason she didn't get that call.
Yes. And, man, 11th turnover here for Dillard. Diaz with a block. And it's going to send Jayla Bibbs to the line.
It's just those careless passes.
Yeah, and this dominant one, Dillard was able to break it very easily in the first half, but seems like, you know, they're starting to shy away from what they had going in the first half, and that's why you see the lead increasing.
And I can understand the pressure on the inbound, but you have to remember, after they score, you can run that baseline. You can make that an easier pass. The guard doesn't have to run and have to go chase after the ball. You can run to them and practically just do a handoff. You can get out and run and have somebody else flash open. Something. You have to do something different right now, because obviously trying to just pass the ball from one spot isn't going to do you a lot with this heavy, with this scrappy this team.
She made both. As Bibbs goes 2 for 2 from the line, stretches the lead to 15 here for Fisk. And you know, Ahmad, you were just talking about it. The ref just motioned to Sylvia Jones that you are able to run the baseline. You can run the baseline. So definitely going to have to take some advantage of that.
You got
to
ask that question almost every time you get the inbound. Hey, ref, can I run the baseline? Especially if you know what team is pressing, because that helps you a lot.
And that's a well-executed press break. Yes. Right there by the Lady Blue Devils.
Attack while they are in transition. They are not trying to get back and play. They are not trying to get back and play set defense. They are trying to take the ball from you as fast as possible. Double.
Buchanan with the drop step. Elbow to the face, maybe?
Oh, my.
Winter Taylor comes away with the rebound. Dillard doesn't have numbers. Gets it to Lowe. Foul. Another foul. And she gets the call. Cassie,
I'm sorry, that first one, me, I don't even see fell. I see you got to be stronger with the ball.
And but the story of the game is, you know, Dillard just pulling it back out after they get out on transition. You know, it's definitely not what you want to do. If you're gonna get out and run, you know, we need to get out and run, right?
Absolutely.
We don't. The point of getting out and running is to avoid running sets and, you know, score before the defense can get set. Lowe makes both here. 45 seconds left in the third quarter. Gibbs in the corner with it. Guarded by Knox. 18 on the shot clock. And that's a nice steal right there by Lowe. And turns it right back over.
I don't know why you slow it down right there, honestly.
Gibbs gets that one to go through the contact.
But plays like this have made the game. You're trying to slow down and get into a sit rather than just trying to get straight to the rim and attack. I think that would make the game would be a whole lot different right now, I believe, if they just simply attack the rim with a lot more a lot more aggression. That's what makes the game, in my opinion, the aggression that you play with, the heart that you play with. You feel me? It's like it's as simple as that. Basketball is not a complicated sport. It's just who wants it more and who's willing to adjust and who's willing to work for it.
John Baptiste takes it to the hole against Buchanan. Gets the foul called there on Jayla Bibbs.
And see right there, that's what aggression does for you right there. You're trying to actually get to the rim, attack, make a move. And now, see, you get another foul right there.
That's going to be the third foul here on Bibbs. Definitely going to be something to look out for in this fourth quarter. But, yeah, like you were saying, Ahmad, it was definitely a good example of, you know, attacking the closeout, making Buchanan guard, and, you know, just forcing somebody to help and make a stop. As Jean-Baptiste gets the first one. And short on the second one. And that'll do it here for this third quarter in the battlefield. Your score, Fisk 59, Dillard 45. We'll be back after a short break on Blue Devil Sports Network. And we're back inside the battlefield here for this fourth quarter between the Fisk Lady Bulldogs and the Dillard Lady Blue Devils. Ahmad, what did you see in that third quarter that Dillard really struggled on and got themselves into this deficit?
Well, turnovers more than anything. A lot of careless turnovers led to a lot of easy buckets and a lot of easy fouls and and-ones on the other end.
Gee outside for three, low with the board, and she's fouled from behind by Gibbs.
Yeah, Dillard, and apparently Dillard had 12 turnovers, roughly 12 turnovers, and almost just the, well, they have 12 turnovers now. But roughly in that quarter, that means they got up to about 7 turnovers.
Yeah, and definitely not what you want to see if you're fighting for a win here late in the season.
No, definitely.
And you know, they're facing a 12-point deficit here. What is going to be some of the keys, you know, for them to get back into this game and coming away with the W?
I say you begin to press and make, see right there, perfect. Half-court press, now can't step back.
Ooh, she traveled. Ooh.
Yeah, the turnover.
Rowe brings it into the front court.
You press and you hurry your team up with not too many guards that play that can make a play. Honestly, you can change the game in a lot of ways. Just like that was a great half court trap right there, because now you force it, because now you got the half court line as an extra defender essentially for you too, and now it's hard to make that half court pass, because now you know that's more than likely going to be a steal. So
And good move on the inside by Gee. Can't get it to fall.
But what I would like to see right there also is that they take away all the close passes rather than trying to leave some far passes, honestly. I think if you take away all the close passes and you force them to make that cross-court pass, that gives your team some time to recover while the ball is in the air or even allows them to make a bad pass and create another opportunity for a fast break.
And excellent defensive possession here. You can see, you know, the traps starting to work. Dillard throwing them. Well, really, Dillard's been throwing these traps at the corners of the court. So, in the right and left corners, and at right when you pass half court in those corners. So, those are definitely the spots that Dillard's going to want to keep getting these fist guards into, and it's just going to make these entry passes a lot harder. And as you see.
What's 12 name?
As Jones throws it away. But, you know, just making tougher entry passes is going to allow your health side defense to get into the back of Buchanan. And on that last possession, Jones was able to draw a charge.
Yes, with Jones being a lot smaller than what Buchanan is, they definitely have to just – I would say, yeah, I would honestly switch that. I would want Baptiste under the rim, and I would want Jones coming through looking for the steal so she can make an easy leak out pass.
And Dillard's still able to get good looks. They're just not falling down here in this one. Gibbs is guarded by Jones.
They're trying to spread it right there. She really could have took that layup right there, honestly. I'm surprised she didn't.
Yeah, Rowe pushing the pace. Swings it to Gee.
Yes, attack.
Gee attacks.
All the way. I'll take that. That's a good take right there.
That's an excellent take. And, you know, that's one of the first times we've seen, you know, Dillard actually get into the paint. Ooh, excellent defense by Gee. And able to draw a foul. But if you saw on that drive, Buchanan didn't even slide over to help. She was on the left block here. All she did was swipe at the ball. That was a makeable layup for Gee. You know, she was just a little bit too strong on it.
Exactly.
But that's got to be something that, you know, not only Coach Rowe sees, but the players see. And, you know, they're going to have to make that adjustment.
Yes, you have to notice that. You have to tell your players. Attack her. She is not trying to guard. She's not trying to make any real plays. She doesn't want to foul. She does not want to foul out more than anything. He's just trying not to foul out. And I can understand that perspective, honestly.
And great show and go right there by Cassidy Lowe. And you see Dillard getting it into the interior a lot easier now. And Buchanan does have three fouls here in this one. So, and that's going to be a Nia Young's third foul as well. So, Both of Fisk's top interior players have three fouls here in this fourth quarter. So they're going to have to continue to be aggressive, continue to attack, and, you know, make these referees make some calls.
A lot of chirping going on to the referee right now.
Dawson kicks to Rowe. Low with it. Gee at the top of the key.
Attack right there. She's giving it.
She has her gate wide open. Definitely want to go left. But she's also trying to send you into that help side.
I see it too.
High post shot from Low. Too short. Fisk bringing it up the other way with Bibbs. Nice back tap there by Gee. Board by, almost by Low. And we have a jump ball. Nice hustle there by both teams. Ball's going to be going to the Lady Blue Devils. So about 6.5 minutes left, nine point game. What would you like to see Dillard, you know, start to improve on as we get into crunch time of this one?
Well, as the time falls, you don't want to rely on a lot of perimeter shots because your shots have not been falling a lot from the perimeter, and you haven't even taken a lot. So what I would want you to do is to continue to attack the rim and try to draw fouls and go up strong, though. You have to go up strong. Like, almost as if they aren't there. That's how you draw fouls. You have to go up as if they aren't there and just be strong with the ball. Two hands on the ball, elbows out, and just try to elevate or get the ball up as high as you can. Right?
Yeah, that's a great help side block right there by Cassidy.
And not even get
Cassidy
the ball as high
low.
As possible. Get it over your defender. I'm fired.
Yeah, and another thing is these Dillard offensive players, they're, you know, shying away from contact. Definitely don't want any contact from Buchanan, but they're shying away from the contact, and that's why some of these shots look a little off the mark and things of that nature. They're not taking it up confidently, and then they just don't want to get hit.
Yeah, I agree.
And they're going to call Sydney Jean-Baptiste with the foul. It's going to be her fourth. And brings Buchanan back to the line. And leaves that one short. Buchanan gets that second free throw to fall. Pushes the lead back up to 10.
And Buchanan is up to a double-double now. I believe she has 29 and 11 as of right now. 29 and 10, exactly. My fault. I'm correct there. Yes, 29 and 10. It's a lot.
No.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, something else.
I think that's a foul. That's definitely a foul, Gabe. Ain't no wall.
Oh, and that's going to be Anaya Young's fourth team foul here in this one. We're in the bonus, so Gee's going to come down to the line. But
now, this was another thing Coach Rowe mentioned, too. She said they didn't make free throws at the end of the game. So now that you're in the bonus, you're going to get a lot more opportunities to get to the line and put a lot more points on the board. So I believe right here, this is what can potentially make or break the game right now if they can knock down their free throws and get stops.
And Dillard shooting 7 for 12 here in this one.
So it's about 55%.
Gee with the first one knocks it down, cuts the lead down back to 9. But, you know, going back to that play where Gee got fouled, Dawson can't, you know, just catch it and stand in that corner. That's a hot spot where they want to trap, especially in this diamond and one. And, you know, that's where majority of the turnovers for Dillard have come from, is that diamond and one, and, you know, them just allowing themselves to get trapped. You have to get the ball, get it right back to the middle, and make the defense rotate.
That's help from the wrong side right there, honestly. I believe you have to help from the weaker side. Well, I know that's going to open up a very easy pass, but that's where you just try to take that charge right there, and you have to have. Easily just get around this. You can easily work around Buchanan and just her force on the inside for sure.
And I saw Gee help from the strong side corner, but it was just a little bit late, unable to deter that entry pass. And Buchanan knocks down the first free throw, her 30th point of the night. Ahmad, she has scored exactly half of her team's points here in this one. Just a dominant performance here by the All-American.
Absolutely. Yeah. Like I said before, you have to take her. You have to make her. You have to make somebody else beat you. That's all you can do. You have to make somebody else beat you. That's as simple as I can put the game plan right there.
Rowe brings it into the front court. Settles for a floater. Too strong. Yes, fouls. And one more and she's gone. So definitely going to want to be kind of passive on the defensive end, but can't be too passive because you're just going to let Buchanan walk all over you.
Yeah.
As Lumpkin gets the second one to go. And see, this is the third time in a row Dillard has ran this exact same set. This is the third time in a row Dillard has made this mistake. Gee doesn't run the baseline. Dawson goes straight to the corner, and they trap her immediately. Definitely not how you want to break a dominant one, and that's definitely not what they've been doing this entire game. So I don't know why they waited until the fourth quarter to try to switch things up, but they definitely need to go back to what was working.
What I hate to see is it just, why not change how you do it? Okay. It's just to a point where my old coach used to tell me, he said, hey, don't ever go to the corner because you just know that's exactly where they want to trap you at, because that's when that middle pass becomes farther. So that's why you just have to just try to go middle or just change the direction of where you're trying to bring that press break to. But more than anything, I blame that on the communication between the guards. Because it was just to a point one time where it's like, well, I'm already open right here. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you to throw the ball early, and now I'm already in the middle of the court, so you can't even trap me. And just tell the inbounder, run the sideline, and force them to respect her as a threat to even get to the rim.
Gibbs kicks to Bibbs. She can't get it to go. We got a foul here on 33. That's Maya Buchanan. That's her fourth foul here in this one, too. So if I'm Dillard, if I'm Coach Rowe, you know, I'm telling my team, attack that paint. Even if you don't get, you know, an excellent look at the layup, you just want to put your body in her and make these refs call a foul.
And you get 4.5 minutes to reduce a 13-point lead. So I believe you just trap here and you attack her. Hopefully you can get her to foul out. You can just continue to just trap the guards and force them to beat you somewhere else other than the paint.
All right, and we're going to come back with this set of free throws after a media timeout here on Blue Devil Sports Network. We're glad to welcome you here inside the battlefield for the fourth quarter of this one. Fisk with a 13-point lead over the Lady Blue Devils, 64-51. We have Winter Taylor at the line. Knock gets the first one to go. And Ahmad, definitely want to dial up some sets. That's getting me inside the paint, inside the arc, and, you know, just attacking Buchanan, making her foul out. And Anaya Young, also their other post player, with four fouls too. So if we can get both of those players out of the game, it just opens up the offense a lot more for the Lady Blue Devils.
But the thing is, they shouldn't be looking to score in sets anymore. You're looking to get being down 11 here. Oh my.
Would have catch that through a double team. And Dillard on the attack. Knox steps into a three, too strong, and rebounded by Bibbs.
Pressure. You must pressure the ball right here.
Yeah, absolutely. The Lumpkins just can't just be standing there, you know, running the offense.
Exactly.
I get that we're in zone, but, you know, the ball, there has to be pressure on the ball.
Exactly.
Skip pass to Davis in the corner. She's short. Offensive rebound by Gibbs. Stolen away by Gee.
So one-on-one
break. Floater by Knox. Good. Cuts it back down to a single-digit lead.
Turn around. Pressure right here. You have to pressure the ball right there. That's the wing right there. Lexi can pick up that, and they can just – and she, and that allows Jordan right there to even jump the pass right there. You have to acknowledge things like that. That's basic communication right there on how you need to run that zone.
That's good defense.
Just wall up. Wall up. Don't foul. Wall up.
Just wall up. Excellent defensive stand. And it's going back the other way.
The
cheerleader
got to give him the ball. I'm making a tribute to give him the ball quicker. I'm sorry. I'm trying to get the ball out. Run. Sorry. All right, let me stop this.
Anaya Young checks back in for the Lady Bulldogs.
Now, you can't run the baseline here. But
you know, the easiest way, the easiest press break, you know, to beat a diamond and one or a 1-2-1-1 is the four across.
Yes.
You know, get it to it in the corner. Hurry up, get it out. Defense doesn't have time to rotate because there's just so many bodies to cover.
Now slow down.
Like, that's where you have to give it to her right here. Jordan Rowe is open. Now we run.
Ooh.
And that's a good move right there by Rowe. Finally attacking Buchanan. You see, Buchanan hasn't played any help side really here in this one. She's just going to swipe at the ball every time. She doesn't want that fifth foul, so you need to use that to your advantage.
Mm-hmm.
As Gibbs with it, guarded by Rowe. 7-point game with just under 2.5 to play.
Yes. To go back on the earlier attempt to press break, that's what I would call the AAU press break right there. To me, I think that died out a long time ago, especially when more teams started to begin to run the diamond and one press or the 2-2-1 press. That's when you have to come up with different things. You have to just get somebody in a certain, like, away from those trap spots. That's all I would tell you. Just get them away from that trap spot.
Yeah. And we've got to go right here. We have numbers. 7-point game. 2 minutes left to go. Dillard building some momentum here in this one. Late in this one. As Gee drop steps into two defenders. And Zipporah Davis walks it down. Kicks to Young, and Young throws it away. They weren't on the same page there.
Got to try to get the ball in quick here.
Yeah, definitely too lackadaisical, you know, corralling the ball, you know, getting it to the ref, getting set up to get the ball inbounded.
I want to see a lot more. Like, it's just a sense of urgency isn't there for me right now. I don't know.
Roll for three off the elevator screen, just short. It's going to be Davis coming back with it the other way. Gibbs gets it across, and the Lady Bulldogs call a timeout. We'll return with the action after this quick timeout here on BDSN.
welcome you back inside the battlefield here at Dillard University. 7-point game here in favor of the Fisk Lady Bulldogs. 1:16 left. Ahmad, what do you need to see from the Blue Devils here on this possession?
Aggression. That's as simple as I can put it, aggression.
As Gibbs dribbling in it.